Right now, we're about to head to this show that our boy Cole Bennett is putting on. Cole Bennett is the founder of Lyrical Lemonade, which is basically like the hip-hop success story on YouTube of 2017, aside from yours truly. I gotta say, he's got like 1.5 million subscribers, and I'm not gonna say he like broke any of these dudes, but like a ton of dudes out there basically would credit their careers to Cole Bennett being a huge factor in it. Lil Xan, Famous Dex, Lil Pump, like he basically helped to blow up all those dudes. So tonight, Lil Xan, Lil Skies, D Savage, Steve Cannon, Shoreline Mafia. We rolling out at the Regent downtown. All right, let's go. Could have been a $15 ride instead of $63 because I got the SUV for the vlog.
Charges to the game.
Charges to the game. Thank you, Dylan.
Yeah. So. What should I play? What's the mood?
It's the best one. I mean.
In the wild.
Oh, it's Mr.
22.
What's up, man?
How you living, bro?
I didn't even know you were here.
I'm here now. I just got here.
I take one more because I look like a fucking midget.
Wait. So what was the dynamic here? Did you ask for a photo with him or did he ask for a photo with you? That's what I was thinking. Tyler asked him. That's how times they are changing, man. Everybody want to be a cuff boy now. So there's this girl, and on the podcast that we did the other day, I talked about how she used to hate on Young Thug when I would play Young Thug around her. And I even like said her fucking Instagram name and shit. So she just hit me up like, why is everybody calling me a disgusting piece of shit in my Instagram comments? I'm like, oh, it's because I said that you didn't like Young Thug. You deserve it. She's cool about it. I was hating on you for not liking Young Thug, LMAO. LMAO, what? I don't even not like Young Thug yet. Changing her opinion. Now I'm listening. Wow, Drake. Lit, Adam. Look at this. Aww. My man Insomniac Rari in here.
You already know, man. Crash Rari, do the dash Rari, nigga.
How you feeling? Talk to me. What's going on in your life right now?
You know, working on new music, man. Famous spaceship, bro. Ghetto greatness. I'm lit as fuck right now. Whole lot of liquor, man.
What are you doing?
So what?
What are you drinking?
This Jameson.
Is this you?
Jameson and Coca-Cola. Mm. Nah, that's Captain Morgan. Jameson and Coca-Cola right now, you know what I'm saying? I drink the Coca-Cola, but I don't do the Coke, so.
Can't relate.
Yeah. Hey, y'all see the glow up? Y'all gotta appreciate the glow up, man. My nigga next level now. He doing amazing things. He got the chain. He icy. he a rapper.
Yo, look at the spread. This is my style right here. And look at my fucking... Look at this Kendama World Champion over here, too. Introduce yourself.
Sue Generous. Upcoming artist. Check me out. XO Sue Generous on Instagram.
I seen his video on live stream. It was crazy. I put it on Twitter, and everybody went crazy. Different opinions. It's a fire-ass song, but it's about drugs. Very young, so.
About drugs.
I mean.
It's about drugs.
Controversial topic, you know?
I got off the drugs, now I'm off the kendama.
I don't fuck with security at all.
Steve Cannon. You don't know Steve. Let's just act like the fucking viewers don't know anything. Steve is part of Lil Xan's Anarchy crew. A little bit older than him. Probably seen him in the vlogs beating the shit out of somebody once or twice in the middle of Skid Row. I think he might have broke his thumb on somebody's head one time in the vlog. And he's opening tonight. He's the first act on the bill. Opening for his boy, Xan. So.
Hey, yo, talk on this soon as Anarchy shit.
Yeah.
Big dog shit. Big boy shit only. So, how you feeling, bro?
How you feeling?
I'm
good. Been a big year.
It's been the best year.
It's been the craziest year.
Hey, and fuck that dude that was dissing on Twitter. About your girl. Fuck
all
that
of
nigga.
Them.
Oh, honey mustard.
Oh, man. It was like hummus for me. When I was in trouble, we was
blowing up. Homemade beef pills, homemade studio. Hotel parties to teach you how to do this.
Surround sound system.
You're gonna put your speaker inside an ice bucket. Turn the whole party up.
A Lyrical Lemonade sandwich.
First off, you guys.
I'm hungry out here, man. Thanks, Paul. Tell me how the fuck you did it. How the fuck you came up so fast last year. Let's hear about it.
I didn't realize like that it was taking off until it took off. You know what I mean? Kind of like I was shooting videos just because I fucked with it. And then like kind of everything just happened. And then like all the artists I was working with, it was just like music I liked. Just happened to be what other people liked too. It just like was a mixture of so many different things. And it just kind of like makes the perfect way.
Probably get 5 million offers or requests to do videos every single day. Like what makes you want to fucking involve yourself?
off of somebody?
Yeah, I like doing everything like organic. And it sounds kind of corny, but like for instance, I like having like good relationships with these people. So that's how like I'm able to work with people in a way that makes me want to do it, and it comes out the best way. If there's a label and they have however much money, I'm gonna always pick what I want to do naturally over that. You know, I don't really care about the craziest offers, because the craziest offers don't always make sense. You know what I mean? You know what I'm talking about. So I really just like fucking people who I vibe with, and I really like their music.
Who were you influenced by in terms of your sort of signature editing style that you're known for at this point? Like, what were you looking at that sort of helped you get to the point where you're at now?
As far as when I first got into it, and I was doing like the drawing animating, probably from the Mac Miller video that he did with like Casey Veggies, and I forgot what song it was. It was like the Ill America one, and they had like this animation. I thought that was the craziest thing, and I was like, I wish one day I could do something like that. And then one day I just taught myself how to do it overnight. And then once I started doing that, I kind of just, everything else that I started doing after that in regards to editing, it just like kind of just happened that way. I was just really big into things like editing that would just pop out and kind of have its own personality, you know what I mean? Because there's always music videos, and yeah, the song's great or whatever, but the video is also good, but it didn't like do anything where you remembered it, you know what I mean? You could shoot a video on a $100,000 camera and have, you know, make it look amazing, but you know what I mean, if it's super simple and there's not much to it, then maybe someone just gonna, you know, think right past it. But if you do something that really catches the eye, then you're also appealing to the visual aspect of things, and then, you know, the visual and the audio, if it all goes together and really is hitting on their level, then bam.
You got Office Space now in Chicago.
Uh-huh.
What's like your vision for the future of Lyrical Lemonade? What do you think it could be?
Yeah, I don't even know. That's the funnest part about it. So I got the office, so, you know what I'm saying, all my boys who helped me with everything and work for Lyrical Lemonade, we could have like a common space, come up with cool ideas, and just have a place not at home. So like for me, the biggest thing was I hated waking up and walking into a room over and starting my day. Like going to work is something that you need to do. You know what I mean? Like no matter what it is, self-employed, you can't just be in your house all day. You need to go somewhere. So that was like the idea with the office. And moving forward, I mean, the show's really taken off, the clothes have taken off, so I keep pushing the blog. So I don't know, festivals, I don't know. I never really know, I just let it happen.
Who do you see blowing up in 2018? I know you give a shit all the time, like I do, but who's your draft picks?
Six Dog going to be superstar.
Just did the Expose with him, for the record.
With Six Dogs? Yep.
Eating a bowl of noodles the whole time.
Dude, he's like, he's gonna be like really fucking big. Young Band, yeah. He'll be big. The Sui, I don't know how to say his name.
Sui Generous?
Yes, I think he'll be big. You put me on here, actually. I think I text you, I was like, who's that kid?
Yeah, yeah.
But rapping about Molly.
He had a pretty fire video too, that like, yeah, his brother shot.
Dude, yeah, this kid's fire. That's a really good question. I know I have so many names I've been waiting to say, and now I can't think of any of them. I think Rari could be big. I love Rari's music. I think Lambs is super dope. I would say Skies
already out of here, right?
Crazy, man. Steven Cannon. Steven Cannon, super dope.
Lil Xan's got to be your craziest success story of 2017, right? Just seeing that video of Rocket.
Yeah, man. That was so crazy, because Xan and I shot that in like 45 minutes. Like, we were drinking like IPA, killing. And then before we released it, we were like, oh, yeah, this is going to be dope. Like, I was excited about it. He's excited about it. But we did not expect that to happen. We released it, and literally like 18 hours later, it had a million views. And we were like, what the fuck? We were texting each other like, what's going on, man? You know what I mean? And then it just kept going up. And then he ended the Hot 100 Billboard, and then now the video has like 90 million views. It's fucking crazy.
But I guess like even Pump was this year, dude, too. So it's like,
bro, Pump
feels like a long time ago.
It happened so quick. That's like, you never know what's going to happen. That's like the most fun about the rap industry right now. You get to literally watch people's lives change so drastically in such a short amount of time. A year ago, Pump was, I mean, everyone talks about it, but he was, you know what I'm saying? He was just a kid. And he still is a kid. Exactly. He was the youth, you know what I'm saying? He smoked burp. It's just like, it's so crazy. He's the biggest thing in rap right now. I don't care what anyone says. He's bigger than, I'm not even going to say anything that's controversial. He's bigger than like a lot of fucking people. You know what I mean? A lot of really big names. And that's so crazy to see. And that just, I think the best part about that is it feeds like, that's motivation for anyone. You know what I mean? Like, that you can have, you can come up overnight.
Cole Bennett coming in hot. Proud of you, man.
Appreciate you, bro. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Look, it's Roy.
Hey.
Shoreline Mafia, big ass crew, man. They always roll hella deep. Can't blame them. Like a real mafia. It's like the Godfather. Like, you're gonna tell fucking Don Corleone, like, no, you're not bringing the homies in. He's like, oh, hell yeah, I am. I like that. But they're young, though.
That's the groove.
This is a rare, rare little moment, man.
I don't even smoke. I don't smoke right now. I had to hit the loud one time. Yeah, I don't smoke.
smoke at all. I don't smoke at all.
You want to lay down?
I gave it up.
You weren't smoking earlier.
I don't smoke at all. I just had to do it off the strength. I'm just lit as hell right now. I'm lit as fuck.
Hey, shout out to LA, bro. Drop my first shit. No, I cannot run from them. I been getting so much money. Fuck the government.
In. It was kind of bad. I fucked up earlier. I got some other hoes in that shouldn't be in here. They might suck some dick, but the other bitch is way better. I fucked up.
Any hoes is some hoes, I can.
Hey, big 22. That's a gang. We already know what it is. Bro, fucking gang, man. Chris man. Longer.
Chris Longer.
Chris fucking Longer. Subscribe to Chris the Ride Longer. TV. Chris Longer, subscribe, nigga.
Yo, the girl on my live, I was asking her if she would date a Jamaican guy. I saw she that. Was like, I was nah.
Nigga, it was 11 o'clock in the morning and you had me rolling. Ugh. It was too early and I was dying.
My IG live was amazing this morning. That's the most fun I ever had.
This nigga said, would you date a Jamaican? She's like, nah.
She's just like, no.
But she was into all this hood ass
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, she told me Draco the Ruler was a fair rapper. I'm like, would you date Hakeem? She's like, I don't know Hakeem. I go, he's Jamaican. She goes, no.
No.
Man, look at the teeth. Look how crazy his teeth look now.
I'm finally a rapper. They still fucked up though.
Yeah. Wild ass year, huh?
Seemed like a lot of people had a wild ass year.
Yeah.
Gang, you already know what's going on. You dig?
Oh, I was about to say here, that's crazy.
They would have a pizza in here.
Greater with DJ.
You want a Xan?
Pressed as fuck. They didn't even get the shape right.
Lil Xan, what do you think of these Xans?
These are pressed as fuck.
Taste test, you down?
With the grill in, no.
You'll never get rid of it. Pressed. Best.
It's see? Not even bitter.
He's my drug testing kit. I was gonna take all of these, but no.
Bro, I think it's cheese.
Xan check.
That's real. It's a real Xan right
there. I don't know.
It's like 6 milligrams.
Oh, that's real. Oh, yeah.
When the time is right, you know when to use that.
Yo, this is one of those green hulks that they be talking about.
Yo, real Xan. That's a real Xan, too, bro.
The real green bar.
I'm gone.
That's the real green bar.
Yo, look. Fake real.
You versus the guy she told you not to worry about. We speak in memes. We only communicate in memes out here, you know?
So I'm all over the table. I got it. Can you buy a Steelers hat?
I actually bought one.
Please. When you do it, put it on.
Why you like Pittsburgh so much?
What? I've been a Steelers fan.
I'm from Ohio,
but I'm a Steelers fan. Everybody chill out.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
It's only crazy. Only reason I said it because we about to play the Jags.
Actually, we
and I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Wake Bortles, baby.
Shut up. I'm sorry you got the Jag hat on because Steelers want to play the Jags.
No. The Steelers are going to destroy
them. Yeah, don't even play around with us like that. Don't play around with that. You heard it live. Steelers beating the Jags.
I didn't even know.
Any nigga, I'll put any money up. We beating the Jags on Sunday.
Hey, guess what's happening on Sunday?
Remember I said that.
Jags are going to win.
Not going to win. It's over for them. I didn't need y'all to know that. Rory said it first. Steelers beating the Jags. You already know what time it is.
I'm trying to eat
real
this gum.
Steelers fans.
I feel like a cat with a hairball.
Hey. Damn, I feel like crying. What?
Gang.
Academics. Yeah, that nigga's a bitch. He's a weirdo. He's a lame. His bitch is a hoe. I'ma slap the fuck out of him. Hashtag still slapping shit. Hashtag viral. Cause it's going viral. You know what I mean? With this nigga. Ooh, you iced out. I ain't never seen that. This nigga getting money. Let me hold a couple.
Shout out to my man Academics. What's good? You got Joe Budden.
Yeah, I fuck with everybody.
Fuck these Academics.
Bitch.
I know every DJ but this good guy, academic. I like academic. I think it's cool that he has beef with people I hang out with too. I like that. I like that in a guy. Boom gang, don't you feel like he should be here? He's just talking to me for the clout. Yeah, I don't even know this guy.
Can't talk to him. Cameras off. Drug dealer business.
For real, yeah. I want to play into that narrative. We sell drugs together. I mean, I'm part of the Healthy Boys cartel.
With my old customers.
You feel me? Yeah. He sold me an ounce of shake one time. On God. Later, guys. There you have it, Lil Xan, Lil Skies. It was a good time. D Savage came through. Everybody's Shoreline Mafia, so hopefully everybody had a good time, enjoyed themselves. We'll be right back at it real, real soon with another video like this. So make sure that you subscribe because you would not want to miss it, would you? Peace.